Treasure seeker.
Watch yourself, white hair.
Too many foreigners in the Isles in the olden days.
Ever faded?
Them supper knives are good for picking your teeth.
Your peel. You drink last night too?
Another one struck and pumped to see.
These continental dandies come a strutting, then we gotta drag their corpses out of the inn.
Take it easy.
Maybe the organs hurt me anymore. I have no clue what they give her.
Maybe a nice little last night was pretty close.
Do you see this?
Friends, we show heart. Foes, we show our axe.
Tired, huh?
Whoa there, Roach.
You're mad, woman! Mad, I say!
Maybe, but I've got good reason.
Very I hold Ciri dear, too. You know this damn well. But the Mask of Orberus is no trifle.
Yes?
Can hear you two clear on the other side of the island.
Good! May all Skellige know... Jennifer of Vengerberg is a common thief!
Control yourself, Druid. I haven't stolen anything. I've merely borrowed something and fully intend to return it.
Ha! The generosity. Just one small problem. Once used, the mask is rendered completely worthless. Not to mention the risk you'll bury us alive and all the Isles with us.
Barry, what are you talking about?
She's not told you? Might have expected as much.
The myth is that Orberus created the mask when the envious seas swallowed his beloved. Unable to bear the prospect that he would never again see his betrothed, Orberus made the mask which would allow him to peer into the past. He knew, however, that he could only use it once. So he waited. Waited until his longing grew so strong that it became unbearable. When the sea learnt of the mask, it was quick to respond. It made known its threat that whosoever used the mask would bring the sea's wrath down on them. For in vengeance, the sea would rise and flood all the lands and drown the living.
So, no one's ever used the mask?
No, but...
So you don't actually know if it works, how it works?
Of course I do. The myths tell me.
You believe the myths?
Only ignorant fools belittle their significance. Besides, it's not the myths that are on trial here. It's the thief.
On the one hand, a theft. On the other, Ciri's life.
I also care deeply for the girl. I proposed a series of other methods. Yennefer refused to listen. She claimed they would take too long. Whereas she needs immediate results. She has always been hot-headed.
True. At least this time she's got a valid reason for it.
Never mind that she might bring... What? What was that? No. Yennefer's used the mask.
Quickly! Follow me! We must neutralize the mask!
What was that?
Unicorns.
Damn it, Yenna. I saw the foglets. I meant how'd they get here.
The power of the mask summoned them.
Ermion says the mask might cause a natural disaster.
Fortunate he's here, then. He can jump right in, try to tame it.
Realize he won't let this pass.
Oh, I'll survive, somehow.
What now?
The mask reveals the past, but only in certain places. Places where past events left a strong magical imprint. Take it.
Want me to wear it?
Yes. I'll cast a spell that will let me see through your eyes.
Gonna read my mind again?
You object?
You do it whenever you want, anyway.
No harm in it, then, is there? Let's go. Already found the first spot. This is the spot. Put on the mask.
Any instructions?
Keep it on until you've seen everything. And don't stray far. Telepathy is limited in range.
What's that? A portal?
Two people emerged from it.
The woman was Ciri.
How can you know?
The way she moved, like a witcher. Seems they went that way.
Come, let's find the next spot. There'll be nothing to pick up when I'm done with you. Ready? Use the mask.
Watch out!
What was that?
A magic explosion of some sort. So powerful that even the echo was dangerous. I wagerit destroyed the forest.
Ciri and her companion weren't harmed. I saw them escape.
Let's see where to.
Place is creepy. I don't like it.
Nor do I.
Anyone here when this happened had a slim chance of surviving.
But don't worry. Ciri can take care of herself.
Don the mask.
Someone chased Ciri. See that? Might have wounded her.
She escaped through another portal.
Know where it led?
Magic residue trail leads to Velen.
Any chance you can figure out where Ciri's companion fled to? His portal's gotta be nearby.
I'll try to find it. Come. Ready? Use the mask.
Nice fight.
One repelled the other with powerful magic, then fled through a portal.
A mage?
Most likely. It's Ciri's companion and the one who wounded her.
How do you know?
I don't. Making an educated guess. They both appeared in the previous visions.
Ciri's got a powerful ally. The mage who was with Ciri fled too. Nowhere?
His trace path leads to Velen as well. But the target coordinates of his portal differ from those of Ciri's. The explosion must have disrupted his teleportation.
Ran into Kira Metz in Velen. Coincidence maybe, but she claimed a mage came to her looking for Ciri. Be surprised if it wasn't the same one.
Whoever he is, he grows more interesting by the minute.
Maybe something left of the one who got hit by the spell.
It's clearing up.
Ermion must be getting a handle on the weather.
Which means he'll be free to attack us again.
Are you pleased with yourselves? Look at what you've brought down on us! If someone's death were to help you find Ciri, would you start making human sacrifices as well?
Relax. Storm's died down. You've clearly got things under control.
For now. But who knows what will be a week or two on?
Stop panicking. Here's your mask.
It is worthless. It's an unwieldy ashtray at best. I hope you've learned something useful at least.
Very.
I'm talking to Geralt. You I'll deal with later. So?
We think a powerful curse was cast here.
Plausible. Considering what happened to the wood, do you know upon whom?
Not yet, but we know Ciri was here. She stepped out of a portal. The mage was with her. Someone chased them. They fought. Ciri was wounded, but managed to escape.
Where to?
Velen, probably. The mage opened a portal for her, then he fought her attacker.
Yes? Is that it?
Got a feeling we've found something interesting. Just need to examine one more thing.
We're flying in that direction.
Something's pinned under that tree. Can you...
I can. Geralt, please move before I'm forced to place it down on what
hill. armor's clean. No blood, no sword nicks. Ciri's friend must have... what do you call it?
Vaporized him.
Exquisite. The armor. All the workmanship's unfamiliar. Can't even tell where it's from.
Probably because it belonged to a rider of the Wild Hunt.
What? So it's true. The Wild Hunt. I feared as much. First here, then on Hindersfjall. What did they want?
They're looking for Ciri.
But why?
Elder blood flows in Ciri's veins.
It is true, she can trace her lineage clear back to Lara Durin, which is why the women in her family have always had extraordinary abilities. But could that truly be so important?
Ciri's exceptional. She travels between places here and other worlds. Space is no obstacle for her.
Huh?
Which is why the Wild Hunt wants to capture her. Speaking of the hunt, mentioned it appeared on Hindersfjall.
Well, it happened at least a fortnight after the cataclysm struck here on Ardskellig. The raids raided Lothotan at dusk in a blizzard. Itself a strange occurrence for that time of year. The islanders set the wraiths. They barged into their huts, killed anyone who resisted, then galloped inland, laughing fiendishly.
Anyone survive?
A dozen or so women, and an old man.
Next stop, Hindersfjall.
I'll meet you on the beach near Lothotan.
Hindersfjall.
Wait, can't we go together? Right now?
But you detest being teleported.
Don't exactly like potions either, but I drink them when I have to.
You also drink them when there's no need at all. Very well. Let's go. Stay close to me.
Good luck to you. Inform me once you've learned anything new.
Yeah, yeah.
Who's that guy? Yeah.
Quite a few years since I was last on Hindersfjall. But if I remember correctly, Lothotan should be this way. Huts and fresh graves. This must be it.
Gathering of some kind. We've come at a bad time.
There's no good time to talk about the Wild Hunt.
That's for real.
Ritual of some kind. We'll have to wait.
We'll do no such thing.
Dear
sisters, pardon the interruption, but we've an important matter to discuss.
Can you not see we're commemorating the dead?
Yeah, seriously.
And we're looking for someone who's still alive. Please, this is urgent. Then speak.
We're looking for a young woman, name of Ciri. Ashen hair, green eyes.
I'm sorry. She is not here.
Unless she lies in a grave. That is, I do not recall one by that name. But I buried so many, I may have forgotten.
She's not dead, yo.
Has she a scar here on her cheek?
Yep.
Yes, what happened to her?
Don't know. Saw her but for a moment. Right before it all. She was in the stables. With Craven. A thousand curses upon him.
This Craven you mentioned, does he have a name?
He did. Until the elders struck him from the saga of ancestors.
It's as if he had ceased to exist. The lore forbids anyone from touching him, speaking to him, even uttering his name.
What did he do to deserve that?
He fled from the Wild Hunt. He alone.
We need to talk to him. Even if it's not in keeping with your customs.
You've come too late. He went to the garden to fight Morkvar.
The fuck?
Morkvar.
A lot of weird words.
What's that?
Her, you mean.
the vilest man ever to inhabit Skellige. Nothing was ever sacred to him. He attacked his own clan's lands, took gold from Nilfgaard, killed children, pregnant women.
Now the time.
They said he feared only one thing, the wrath of the gods. Borgvarg sought to prove how wrong they were, so he sailed to Hindisfjall to ransack the goddess's garden.
Are you guys, like, delaying us? Because he's gonna die when you get there pretty soon.
He thrust a blade between her ribs and cast her down in the mud. As her lifeblood left her, she cursed him, and Morkvarg transformed into a beast.
Curse? A monster? You've got some work to do.
I can get rid of Morkvarg. Don't know what he's turned into, but a silver sword should do the trick.
It's not that simple. There have been those who have bested Morkvarg, yet he always returns.
So, it's a complex curse, meaning I need more information.
I understand, but I've told you all I know.
Speak with Toradar's son, Einar. He was in the garden when Morkvarg and his men attacked. He saw what happened. Of all the pilgrims there at the time, he alone escaped with his life. He settled in Larvik. You'll find him there at the landing, provided he's not out to sea when you arrive.
Where is this holy garden?
Not far from here. North. We cultivated healing herbs there once.
And now?
Herbs,
now
huh?
We walk only as far as the tree the goddess planted. We place our offerings and make our pleas before it.
Those who venture below remain in the garden forever.
It's a pretty sad life.
Thanks for your help.
I understand you intend to enter the garden. I dislike it when foreigners enter the sacred grounds, but so be it.
Hey, you guys aren't helping me much.
Offering of their own blood before the tree. Craven surely did so. Unless he lacked not only courage, but respect for Freyr as well.
You needn't worry about us. Geralt and I always give the gods the respect they are due.
Okay. Well, let's go then, shall we? Guarded treasure, huh? What's guarding it, though? A wraith? Where you at, motherfucker? Oh, man. Damn it. Yan isn't helping me out, huh? These pole swords. Why are you taking so long, huh?
Worried this trail might have gone cold.
Even if Raven's dead, we'll manage. Hey, Geralt, come back.
Ugh.
How exactly?
You'll see when the time comes.
You could stand to be nicer sometimes.
I suppose. But then I wouldn't be the woman you fell in love with, would I?
No, you probably still would be.
My, my. That must be Morkvarg.
A bite. Just one morsel. One piece. A crumb. Fade.
Looks like a werewolf.
Shank! Not again! Not again!
Ah! doesn't seem happy to see us.
Wait till he gets a closer look at me.
So, where should we start?
Let's go to that tree the sisters mentioned.
Plan to bleed yourself for the goddess?
Not necessarily, but Craven did. We just might pick up his scent. Craven was here. Look, the impression. Kneeled down on one knee, and cut himself to make the offering. Bloodstains, see them?
No. I may be inhumanly beautiful, but I don't have superhuman senses. Not like you.
Which is why you should stay up here. No offense, but in that undergrowth and mud, you'd be like a...
ball and chain?
Planned to say it gentler, but yeah, that's basically what I had in mind.
Fine. We'll do as you say. If the need arises, I can cast spells from up here.
Fine. See you later then.
Don't get hurt. Remember, I need you if I'm to find Ciri. Oh, come. I was just teasing. Fool. I need you. Period. Better?
Better. Craven's blood, flowing profusely. Trail's clear. Should lead me to him. Something down there. Can't see a thing. Light prints. Craven trod carefully. Bite marks. Morgvarg doesn't eat his victims. Strange.
Is it Craven?
No, this one's been here a while.
What? I can't hear you. If you want to chat, come closer.
Her senses are really dulled. Sneaking around and attacked. Craven's blood. Craven was injured, started running. Craven's blood. Budge. Craven must have blocked it, or it's just locked. Gotta go round. These prints should lead me to Craven, or his body. Come on.
Lots of prints, old and new. His lair must be nearby. Can't cross that. Gotta go down, provided I can open the sluice. Mechanism looks pretty standard. One lever to choose the sluice gate, the other to work it. Looks like rain. Lead to the well. Guess Craven didn't want to be eaten, preferred to drown. Roots, I'm right under Yen.
Hey, can you hear me?
What? You scared me.
Sorry, didn't mean to.
I hope not. Let me know once you find Craven.
Yen, found him.
And?
And I've seen rot fiends in better condition than this.
Shit. Fine, scrape together what you can and haul the bits up here.
Yen, there's no point.
There's no point in discussing this through a grate. We'll talk when you get here, all right?
That's Yen, charming as ever. Come on, someone wants to meet you.
Oof. Putrefaction set in. But the vocal cords are intact. We might still get something out of him.
Doesn't look like the talkative type.
Anyone can be made to talk. Even a corpse. One must simply know how.
Thought necromancy was strictly forbidden.
So is premarital sex. But I'm not about to be bothered by such foolishness.
Black magic's no joke. Casting those spells never ends well. Never.
I don't like it any more than you do, believe me. But the thought that Ciri is in danger, I like that even less.
I understand. Still doesn't give us the right to...
Geralt, please. This is not the time to debate ethics.
Need any ingredients for the spell?
The blood of a newborn, a virgin's tongue, and the eye of a newt.
Mind trying again without the sarcasm?
I don't need a thing. I'm a sorceress, not a village herbalist. All I need is energy. A great deal of energy. We're very lucky this place is saturated with magic.
It's also considered sacred. Priestesses will be furious if you use the garden's power to revive a corpse.
Geralt, you're getting on my nerves. I offer you solutions, you try to poke holes in them.
Sorry to bother you with my doubts.
Please, Geralt.
That's just it. Your please is never a request, only ever a command. But let's move on. Let's get to work.
Selene, Selene, Dufresne! Selene, Selene, Davidar!
Of Lofoten.
No, I have a name. I am Skjalf.
We're looking for Ciri, ashen hair, green eyes. Have you seen her?
She's wise. Curse me.
I don't care about that. What happened to her? What was she doing here? Speak!
No!
Speak! Speak!
She fell! Almost! Drowned!
Ciri. Zirel. Can you hear me?
I can.
I must leave you now. We will meet beneath Drowned Dead Rock. Can you remember?
Mm-hmm.
Repeat it.
Drowned Dead Rock.
You're awake. And I thought you'd...
Where am I? And who are you?
It's all right. You're on Hindersfjall, village of Lofoten. They call me Skjal.
But how'd I... What?
We fished you out of the sea. Me and that friend of yours.
And where is he? My friend?
Stepped out a while ago. Said he needed to find a boat. Why does he wear that mask? Something not right with his mug?
No. He simply doesn't like others to see it. Help me stand.
I don't think you should...
Less talk, more giving me a hand.
Ah, that's me brother for you. Out of sight for a second, and he's already put his paws on a girl.
Astrid, you're as dim as dishwater. You know perfectly well I'm helping her up.
It's a shame, I know, but I've got to interrupt your courtship. Come, we're off to the sauna.
Where?
Why is your mouth agape like you're noodling for an eel? The sauna. Girl, you was blue as a whale when we brought you in here. Your blood needs thawing.
I'm sorry. But I must get to Drowned Dead Rock. As fast as possible.
I shan't force you to stay. But the rocks are ways off and you can barely walk. You'd best take a horse.
True. Skjall can prepare a horse for you. You'll have to wait a spell, but even so, you'll get there faster than on foot.
Fine. That'll do. Thank you both very much.
Pish posh. There's no need. Now come. We gotta sweat the sick out of you.
Where are my clothes?
I've taken them already. Come on. That man in the mask. He's from afar, isn't he?
Oh, yes. From very far away.
Where exactly?
Aren't you nosy?
Surprised? I've been sitting in this fish puddle my whole life. I'd love to travel like you.
Like me? No, you wouldn't like that. Trust me.
Keep your elbow up, your arrow goes straight.
I know, but the arm hurts.
Good. Means your muscles are working. And mind the string don't catch on your nose.
Ah! I know!
In you go and get out of those rags.
All of them?
I should think so. Let's go. I'm getting goose pimples.
Finally. I was so worried you'd...
Ach, Mum, you always worry. Everything's fine, ain't it?
Mm. Yes, it's fine.
Good. That's good. What's on your thigh, child? That a bruise?
This? No. It's a tattoo.
So it is. A red rose. It mean anything?
No, it means that I was young and drunk. And it happened. At least it's not terribly visible.
I like it. Wouldn't mind one myself. Here, right above me rear.
Ach, you need a man, girl. Get more foolish every spring. Here we are, gabbing away. Steam's gone. Gotta douse the coals.
Say, back home, have you got saunas too?
You know, I don't really have a home. I'm a traveller.
Ah, that's right. Where was your ship headed?
Ship?
We fished you out of the sea. We thought you were in a shipwreck.
Yes, my ship. We set sail from Novigrad.
And what brings you to Skellige?
I'm here looking for someone.
Not your betrothed, I hope.
Why?
It'd break Skjall's heart. He's head over heels for you, girl. Sat at your bedside all the day, staring like you was painted by a master.
Astrid, I asked you not to tell her.
Oops. Well, now the milk's spilt. Do you fancy Skjall?
Well, he seems... nice.
Oh my. He's that bad?
Leave it, Astrid. Who she likes is her affair, and it's not to you.
And It's lovely sitting here with you, but I really must go now.
I understand. Who'd want to stay in this hole? We're all related three times over and the air stinks of fish.
I can't see how you're related to anyone here. No one in Lufferton groans and bitches quite like you do. Sit down and be quiet. Chain. Skjald's certain to have readied the horses by now. But before you go, you ought to take a quick jump in the water. It'll do you good.
I suppose. Why not?
Head through the door and you'll see the pier. Be careful, it's slippery.
Thank you, once more.
And once more, there's no need. Gods bless your journey.
Storms are coming. Gotta go to your mom. Tell her to take...
Oh, you're here. The horses are ready.
As am I. Shall we ride?
Listen, I hope... My sister, she didn't talk any nonsense to you, did she?
No. Except to mention that you fancy me.
What? But I asked her... Besides, it's not... Of course, you are very... But... You know what? Let's ride. You're in a hurry and it'll be dark soon.
You're right. I hope to come back here one day. We can finish our conversation then.
Sounds dangerous.
I didn't intend it to.
I'll take Njord. You can ride Greyback. She's old, but she'll make the...
Run for your lives!
You stay here! I'll go and...
I can look after myself.
Thank you. What? What was that?
The Wild Hunt.
Ragnarok. The world's end.
No, not yet. But I must go. They're here for me.
Get on the horse. I'll show you the way to the rock.
I don't know how to thank you.
You can thank me once we get there safe. Let's ride.
Watch out! Ride, silly! Don't look back! Faster! Faster! They're catching up!
What became of that creature? Where is he? What?
I saw him and stood up, but he sold him.
To whom?
Sold. I guess it's the least we owe. Going through the torture of necro interrogation.
She's fucked up.
Did you kill this tree?
Like I said, the spell, it requires a great deal of energy.
You knew it would end like this, didn't you? Didn't consider it worth mentioning?
No. I knew you'd protest.
Your sense of decency is charming, but it does get in the way sometimes.
Ugh.
Could have shown some sympathy for the boy.
That was no boy, Geralt. It was a hunk of rotting, rancid flesh that spoke through my magic.
Didn't just speak, it howled in pain.
I know it seemed real, but it was no longer human. Do you understand?
Do you?
Nice of you to be so concerned for the corpse, much more than you were for me.
Yen, are you all right?
I'm splendid. I'd feel even better if I hadn't had to remind you to ask that question.
Yen, let's get out of here. Now.
You needn't ask me twice.
The garden! Our garden! How could you? We helped! And you! Inconceivable!
Now.
Don't you dare try to calm me! We've every right to be furious! Furious! And you! You will pay for this!
We had no choice. We'd never have learned what happened to her.
Do you really think you're justified? That your hunt for a foreign woman gives you the right to destroy our garden?
I'm sure it doesn't in your eyes.
I shall make sure all Skellige hears what you did here.
Wait. I did this. I alone. Geralt tried to stop me. I refused to listen.
I might have known. They warned me about you. Sorceresses. None shall open their door to you. None shall feed your hunger. And none shall tend to your wounds.
Well, small price to pay to get a whole countryside mad at you.
Yen, you didn't have to do that.
But I wanted to. I'd rather not talk about it. We must focus on what Skell told us.
Key to finding Ciri is that ugly thing Skell saw on the beach. That's what I think. You know, I saw something. Or someone who looked just like that.
Where?
In Velen, in a castle until recently ruled by a self-proclaimed baron, now controlled by his right-hand man, Sergeant Ardal.
Yeah, that's right.
We must go and get the creature. I don't know, buy him, kidnap him.
The thing is clearly cursed. Its mind is a jumble, can't have anything resembling a normal conversation with it.
Grumbling won't get us anywhere.
All will be well.
A curse, please. Nothing a sorceress and a witcher couldn't handle. Now, tell me, do you... No, never mind.
What?
You were gonna ask me something. What was it?
Tell me, do you think... Is there a chance that thing might be seen? That, well, she's been transformed by some curse?
Don't even want to think about it.
Geralt, we must.
Might be. From what I know, she was looking to cure a powerful curse while in Novigrad. But I'll lose it if I try to deal with that possibility now. We have to do what we can, see what happens.
That would be pretty weird.
Didn't learn much, though we can be sure Ciri's not in Skellige anymore. Not in Velen or Novigrad either. She's disappeared. Again.
Perhaps we should re-examine what we've learned. We might have missed a clue that would push us forward.
Certainly hope that's the case. Makes me wonder what she's gotten herself into.
Can't even begin to imagine. But we will pull her out of it. Safe and sound. That I promise you.
Ciri's trail in Skellige. We followed it, exhausted the possibilities. Might be time to go back to the continent.
Before you do, there's one thing. It's important.
What's that?
Let's meet in Larvik, at the Warriors' Hall. We'll speak there.
Can we do this later? Sorry, need to take care of something.
Well, if you must, you must. I shall wait for you in Larvik for a time. If you don't make it, we'll meet in Vizima. After all, we do owe the Emperor a report.
Ciri's our concern, ours alone.
Perhaps. But that is not what we agreed with Emir. We must see him.
If we gotta, we gotta. So be it.
We'd never have known Ciri had returned if not for Emma and his agents. We owe him this.
See you, Yen. Take care of yourself.
Wait. This matter in Larvik is important to me. I'd appreciate it if you didn't tarry.
Monster tracks. Running. Chasing something.
Key? Ramond? Where's the key? All I have in the chapter house, the crate, but the key? Where's the key? Why so silent, Ramond? You thief, you rogue, you whoreson, you worthless bastard! I will find the key without you, idiot, stupid prick! Thank you. is the curse. Makes me bite, scratch, mangle, till I drop. You've got time before the blood's gone from me, and I return. Listen, carefully. Undo the curse. Free me. Finally, I will reward you.
So, no joy in being a werewolf?
Nay. It's the worst. Not the garden to which I'm bound, even. But the hunger. Anything I devour turns to ash. Ash I cannot eat. I cannot drink. Yet I bloody live and roam and prowl. The hunger is terrible. I bite my own flesh, but the smallest morsel burns my throat like boiling tar.
Everlasting hunger. Classic as curses go. Goes to explain why all those corpses went untouched.
Help, or I'll return to shred you, rip your limb from limb.
See what I can do.
See and do, or I shall return.
See if we can do this the easy way. Morkvarg, of my own free will, I offer you this fare. Now dig in.
Won't turn to ash.
Won't know until you try. Come on, a spoonful for Daddy.
Fuck! This shite again!
Farewell.
See you soon.
Ideal friend. Patient, doesn't mouth off. Thank you. fell through the crevice years ago. Air's moving here. Must be another cave above or way out.
Not your lucky day.
You and the sorceress.
Friends, we show heart. Foes, we show our eyes. Sure.
You're a you, dimwit! Drop one more and I'll keelhaul you!
Got a minute?
Preparing my boat, can't you see? Nilfgaardian dogs for the hunter's son.
Got bigger game in mind. Morkvarg.
Ah, so them's your apples. All right, ask away. In praise of Freya.
You were there when Morkvarg raided the garden. Heard you alone survived.
True. I managed to flee. Great Mother was looking out for me that day.
Mm-hmm. Bet she didn't give a lick about the priestesses.
Apparently. Morkvarg had them bound and slit their throats like horses for the sacrifice. And he laughed Understand? He laughed. But Archpriestess Ulver cursed him with her dying breath. You are beastly now. Remain so forevermore. Ah, saintly woman. Liar.
What? I swear it on the great mother's tits.
Cut the act. Don't buy your piety one bit. You were one of Morkvarg's men.
Well, well. Sharp yarn. Didn't see one thing, though. Lads here around me, they're mine. Armed to the teeth to the man. Let me introduce you.
Can't wait.
You're daft. You're alone. What's your plan, eh?
Let me show you.
His long search for Ciri led Geralt to conclude that Uma, the ugliest man alive and the victim of a curse, was the key to finding the young woman.
Yorra, you dimwit! Drop one more now!
Got a minute?
Prepare my...
Got bigger game.
Ah.
You were there when Morkvarg...
True. I managed to flee. Great Mother was looking out for me that day.
Mm-hmm. Bet she didn't give a lick about the priestesses.
Apparently. Morkvarg had them bound and slit their throats like horses for the sacrifice. And he laughed. Understand? He laughed. But Archpriestess Ulver cursed him with her dying breath. You are beastly now. Remain so forevermore. Ah, saintly woman.
Didn't help the priestesses. Why not?
How could I? Alone against a dozen raiders that... Why are you staring?
Just wondering. You people, obsessed with honor, courage, and so on. But you just cut and run? Strange.
I ain't proud of it. Since that day, I've been seeking a worthy death at sea. Seems the goddess, she's not seen fit to summon me yet.
What happened to Morkvarg?
Hard to believe. But fur rose through his skin, and his mug stretched forth into a muzzle like a dog's or a wolf's. He howled, long and grieving, then lunged at his men. They tried to run, but he was fast as lightning. As he killed them, clamped his jaws round their throats, they turned to ash, just like that. Ash that seeped from twixt his fangs.
Not good. Curse must be complex, multi-leveled.
Such is the Great Mother's power.
Liar.
What? I swear it on the Great Mother's tits.
Cut the act. Don't buy your piety one bit. You were one of Morkvarg's men.
Well, well. Sharp yarn. Didn't see one thing, though. Lads here around me, they're mine. Armed to the teeth to the man. Let me introduce you.
I'm no knight errant. I'm a witcher. Didn't come here to bring you to justice.
Digging up the past? What's that for?
Need to know what actually happened in the garden. Gonna lift Morkvarg's curse.
Why would you bloody do that? Horson should suffer till Ragnarok. The day after, actually.
It's what I do.
Used to say the same myself, till Morkvarg gave the order to sail for Hindisfjall. I've raided often and cruelly. Killed women, children, whatever my axe happened to hit. But priestesses, it was too much, even for me. When it was over, and Morkvarg was drinking with the rest, I took this out.
Wolffang pendant, covered in runes.
I got it from my Dar, who was god eye of our village. Told me that anyone I cut with a fang would suffer a fate worse than death. Spoke true, it seems.
Your pop-pop mentioned how to reverse this?
Victim needs to get the fang, is all. But I'll not give it to you. That Horson should suffer.
Listen, the priestesses, they really long to get their garden back. And as I see it, you owe them, don't you think?
All right, take it. But it don't come free. Want one thing in return.
Won't tell anyone about your past, give you my word.
Not that. If you do, I'll just find you and kill you. Once Morkvarg's human again, you can't let him leave. No matter what.
Much left. Beast must have dragged the shredded body to the woods.
mankind. God, end this. Release me.
Mentioned a reward of some kind.
Raided, drunk most away, but all but one. True treasure, hid away, yours.
Here, put this on.
I need no more fangs.
Don't be a smartass, just do it.
Free! At last! Oh, where's the tavern? I could eat a broiled pig. No, a side of beef. Wash it down with a cask of ale. Then to sea. They forgot me, no doubt. Well, I'll fucking remind them with a bang. In Novigrad, everywhere. I'm back!
Fair winds and all, but before you go, my reward?
Right. Nearly forgot.
Happens often. Too often.
Calm yourself. I'm a man of honor. Now listen. You'll go to Novigrad. To the pits. Find the Vulture, the Moneylender. Tell him Morkvark sent his regards. And you'll know me to be a generous man. Farewell, then. The sea beckons.
Oh, that other guy's gonna be mad at me. Seems like the rain stopped.
Come on now.
That's it, Roach.
Hey there.
You who grant us love, hatred, and strength. Greetings. What may I help you with this time?
Morkvarg, got a few more questions. I've come for my reward.
But can you be sure that...
Morkvarg's gone, for good. Guaranteed, or you'll get your coin back.
I shall hold you to that, Witcher.
You who grant us love, hatred, and strength.
beg your pardon.
Nah.
The gods will never forgive you for this.
He ain't welcome here, witch.
So, there's truth to that lie in the ice giant.
To go and defile the Garden of Freya. A hollow curse,
wench.
Always did know how to win, friends.
I was provoked.
Saw it happen. Wanted to talk to me about something?
Amos Far Ipsis.
I actually didn't see it happen.
A specialist on djinns. Heard of him? I found a tome he'd penned in the Emperor's library. Far Ipsis set off for Skellige one day and was never heard from again. I asked some of the local folk. Some here still remember him.
They know what happened to him?
The locals say they last saw his ship off the coast of Hindisfjall. Then a once-in-an-eon storm broke.
So he's probably fish food by now.
Not necessarily. I must learn what became of him.
Why? Do you know him?
No. It's not the mage who interests me. It's his djinn.
Djinn, huh? I gotta borrow that for you.
Why are you even interested? Djinns are dangerous sometimes, and malicious all the time.
I remember. But the advantages outweigh the risks. If I can tame a djinn, I shall gain incredible power. And that could be useful to us one of these days.
All right. So what exactly do you expect me to do?
You must help me find this djinn. I have no gold to offer in reward. But I shall be ever so grateful.
Since you put it that way, fine. I'll help you.
Thank you. A boat awaits in the harbor. Come.
Went into the mine. Greetings.
See, you've managed to prepare everything already.
I have.
How could you possibly know I'd agree?
I didn't. Decided to risk it.
Well, that's honest. I could have just said no, but then I'll lose out on the experience points.
Lead the way.
Just once, you might try to take the initiative.
Would you even let me?
It would depend on the situation.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah, hopefully that guy doesn't know that I let that one other guy live, because that'd be awkward. I'm walking right past him. Wow, that's a little boat. It's a dinghy.
The ship carrying the djinn sank somewhere in this area.
Not too precise as leads go.
I'll cast a spell on our boat. We'll know if there are any wrecks on the seafloor below us.
Doesn't right, make the boat any better.
Mind if I take the helm?
I got a choice.
No.
Yeah, well, whenever you're ready.
Geralt, how long must I wait? Are you ready to
wait for what? No, I'm just, it says just get on the boat. I'm on the boat.
Getting in or not? Geralt, how long must I wait? Are you ready to sail?
Not sure this djinn thing's a good idea.
We managed to seize one before. Do you remember?
Of course. Dandelion almost lost his voice that time.
How lucky your exorcism saved it. It was poetic.
Yeah, how was I supposed to know that incantation meant be gone and plow yourself?
You should have studied foreign languages.
Gonna keep bringing that up for the rest of my life.
Of course. Your last wish effectively assured it.
My wish was about us being together always, not about you mocking my every mistake.
Careful what you wish for.
And when your wish is granted, you must accept it with all attendant circumstances.
Yeah.
And as for your missteps, I don't rightly see why I shouldn't laugh if they're amusing. There's something here, on the bottom. It's too deep here. You can't dive that long.
You underestimate me.
On the contrary. After all, I asked you for help. I'll cast a spell. It will slow your heart for a time. You can stay submerged longer.
Asad I cried a rithorn.
Ready. Careful down there.
How's it going?
Yeah, you know I hate it when you read my mind.
Strictly speaking, I'm not reading your mind, but using telepathy. Besides, you've nothing to hide, right?
Wouldn't admit it if I did. Not the point.
See anything interesting?
A shipwreck and a cavern. I'll look inside. Busted planks, and a whole swarm of drowners. Probably drawn by the corpses of drowned crew that made their nest here. There's also a Clan Drummond figurehead.
Not the right ship. Come back up.
Now.
Wherever the leads take us.
Say we find the djinn. What'll you do? Ask for a beautiful house? And a palace? And a queen's crown?
Are we still talking about the djinn? Or have we moved on to a talking fish?
Doesn't much matter. Both make wishes come true. What would yours be?
You'll learn in due course. Something's here. Another wreck.
Let's see if our djinn's down there.
Look around, but be careful. Look for something that might indicate it's the Major's ship.
got a chest. Now that's what I call more voodoo.
Have you found the djinn?
No, but I found something that could be just as valuable to me as the djinn is to you. Beautiful craftsmanship.
What do you have?
A war horn, bearing Clan Haymai symbols. Something. A Skelliger's buckler. Clan Haymai symbols.
Donar's clan.
Donar was a babe in swaddling clothes when this buckler landed here. Longship belonged to Clan Dimon. Yen. Doubt any of these boats were the mages. These are old sunken longships.
Come back then. We must search elsewhere. You're getting better at this.
Go even quicker if you helped me down there.
I prefer to observe matters from up here, most definitely.
Yeah, like when we were looking for the Golden Dragon and the avalanche swept us off the trail. Me clinging to the remains of a bridge for dear life, you gripping my waist, admiring the view. Remember? Chasm below us was breathtaking. Rustling trees, a lazily flowing stream.
I remember. Though I found myself admiring what I had right in front of me. Something strange about those rocks.
And there's something on the bottom. I'll see what it is.
See something?
Something doesn't do it justice. A huge crater, as if a meteorite landed here.
I must see it.
Diving in after all?
No, I shall cast another spell to see through your eyes. Now relax. Aisu faltia badem ein eichte ilivaid. That is no meteorite crater.
What is it then?
The effect of teleportation. A powerful force cut out a fragment of the seabed, rocks, and everything lying within the teleportation zone.
Always claimed portals were dangerous.
I believe we're on the right track. Look for anything that might contain a djinn.
Fine, but get out of my eyes. Too cramped in here for us both.
Aisu faltia badem ein eichte ilivaid.
Silver, pearl-encrusted cutlery. Ship belonged to someone awfully wealthy.
Amos was no pauper. It could very well be his ship.
Something cut this basket exactly in half. Something cut this basket exactly in half.
Thank you.
only found half. Can you do anything with this?
I can use it to locate the other half, to within a dozen yards.
And once we find that, we should find the djinn.
Exactly. Ready? I'll take us there on the count of three.
Oh, no, not another portal.
Stop whining. One, two... We must search the area.
Yen, not so fast. Gotta tell me what this is about first. Why do you want this djinn?
But you already know. A djinn's power is priceless to a mage.
I thought you were a sorceress.
That I know. But I also want to know how you plan to use it. Wouldn't go to these lengths if it wasn't something important.
You're right. It's important. Even very important. How long has this been going on, Geralt? This thing between us? 15, 20 years? We repeatedly split up, then return to one another. Something draws us to each other, but I can never be certain if it's a true feeling or merely a bit of mischief by a djinn.
So that's it. This is about my last wish.
You asked that djinn to bind us together forever. I want to ask this one to take that wish back.
Wow.
Why would you want to do that?
To see what it's like without it. To see if we'll still matter to one another. Or if we'll be like two strangers.
Wondered that myself many times.
You see? We're just a step away from learning the truth. Come, let's search the ship.
This is like a, are we in love for real or is it just a wish, isn't it? Man, how'd they teleport up here?
Seems Amos was quite the eccentric, asking the djinn to lift half his ship to a mountaintop.
He didn't necessarily. Djinns are inherently mischievous. This one might have granted his wish and perverted it in doing so.
In that case, I'd appreciate it if you didn't wish I'd disappear from your life.
I've yet to decide how to word it. We should explore the ship.
A pot fell over.
Interesting here.
Some scissors fell over.
Very interesting.
A box. Oh, I'll take some of that. And some of that, some of that. What we got here? Some of that. Oh, some of that. Let's see.
Interesting.
Oh, look at that. Some boots fell over.
Looks like the impact with the mountain was so powerful it popped the wearer right out of them. Mage must have slept his means.
But what does it mean?
Blood. Someone was dragged across the deck. War left this mark when the ship suddenly tipped to one side. Nothing here.
Something else on the ground. Well, it sure take a long time to analyze this thing just to say that it's nothing.
Elemental Empires by Jean Batista.
All right. What am I looking for? Some blood. Person got hurt. Gee. Interesting information. You're not really looking for anything. You're the one with the magic. Go down here, it shows the map of the full boat, but there's obviously nothing over here. your senses aren't telling me nothing new. Some blood are there. What am I looking for? Oh shit. Not that way, not that way. No. Could have been a bad one. Ugh.
Blood.
Someone oh, I can move this. The deck. Why wasn't it yellow? Whoa, what the?
Yeah, I think you should see this.
What do you have?
Oh.
It's Amos. Looks exactly like the etching in the book. Except his head was intact.
If he died while being teleported, Seal might still be on him. Behold.
Bravo. Come to the deck. I've an idea.
All right.
Colds preserved the corpse. Died from head trauma. Bookcase cracked his skull. Must have been a hard landing atop this mountain.
Wow. Quite the view. Can't really see much over there. Oh, he went up there.
Step back a bit.
What are you going to do?
Summon and tame the djinn. It's not likely to be happy. Stand at the ready.
Alright.
Tame djinn. Rif kaishta el gaya. Kaishta et displer. Gevirat mi castle.
Really gotta do it like on this boat that's just on the edge of a cliff. Robin Williams? Oh shit.
You must weaken him while I draw him into the sphere.
Care to trade places?
Damn it. I'm not really sure how to damage something that's not even really there. You dead? God. I don't even know what's going on there. a certain degree of control over everything you do. Superior. What do I need? That's weird. I don't have the basic ingredient for it. Well, what about the oil? I can do that. So no magic spell is really gonna help, except for the shield.
Step back a bit.
What are you going?
Some
came.
There he is. Gosh. Oh shoot, why was that equipped? Would he go away? Why'd you put your sword away, man? Oh, fuck. Yeah. to you. Nice face.
Your master died before uttering his last wish. I cannot capture you. We can struggle like this for eternity, or I can release you. If you do one thing for me. Do you see the spell that binds us? Only a djinn can remove another djinn's spell. Remove this one and you'll be free.
So this is like in a divorce? Like you killed him. Is that what being free is?
Storm's over.
Yes. It's all over.
Maybe we should sit. We look a bit dazed.
I'm not, but we can sit. Told you, I'm fine.
Don't need to play tough for me. That was a hard fight. Maybe not as hard as the last time we tamed the djinn, but still.
No comparison, I'm afraid. Half of Rhind suffered then. Now I'm merely a bit tired. Thank you for coming, Geralt. I'd have had a much harder time of it on my own.
You would have done it by yourself?
Well, never could say no to you.
Perhaps that will change now.
Feel anything? That anything's different?
I expected... I don't know what I expected, actually. A bit of vertigo, perhaps. I thought... you'd become a stranger to me. That I'd look at you and not feel a thing. But it's not like that at all. Nothing's changed.
Sorry, but I don't want to be with you.
You might have cheated us after all.
Why?
Because I don't feel that anything's changed either. I love you, Yen.
And I love you.
Dang.
Light.
Strange. Done that so many times. But it felt like our first kiss to me.
It was, in a way. Besides, once you say I love you, a kiss has to taste differently.
Maybe we ought to test a few other things. Amos's cabin looked cozy.
Not so fast, Geralt. We'll have plenty of time to visit cozy cabins later. But I doubt the world will end if we sit here a while.
The
my
end.
Lovely.
Think the spirits of Skellige favor us.
next time we go on horseback.
A horse would never make it down that mountain.
What now?
Well, I'm due to appear in Azima.
That's about it for now. Gonna have to do some repairs.